Good evening, Postmaster.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Do you remember how you learned to read? Have you thought about how will you teach somebody to read? I had to think about these questions, for it was time for me to teach my daughter to read, and I didn't know. So I called my mom. Mom, how did you teach me to read? She said, I put up a chart of ABCD. I put up charts of objects and repeated over time, and eventually you started to read. So she said, I memorized everything. So I didn't think this way of memorizing would help or would suffice for my daughter, because it's more than a million words in the English dictionary. Next, I thought I would call my sister, for she has a son who is about 5 years elder to my daughter, and they're supposed to have crossed the stage. So dear sis, how did you teach him to read? She said, synthetic phonics. I said, what is that? Can you tell me more? She said, there is a colossal change happening in the world with the way English is taught and learned. It is called letters and sounds. Now I got really curious about this and I researched about it. So whenever we see a word like cat, we put together the sounds k, at. We have associated the letter C to make the sound k. Now I know at first blush you'll be like, what is this? What are you saying? That is because I'm trying to make you conscious about a subconsciously self-taught process. We have all, while learning ABCD, understood that the letter C makes the sound k. Synthetic phonics, it is about teaching the sounds of a letter first. Now, how many letters are there in the English alphabet? We agree that there are 26 letters. How many sounds are needed to read correctly? Any guesses? 44 sounds. We need 44 sounds to read eloquently. Now, there are some sounds which are formed with a single letter, and there are some sounds which are a combination of two letters. It could be two vowels, two consonants, or a vowel and a consonant. Example, ow, letters OU in found, sound, about. Another example sound, ch, the letters ch in chin, cheek, chair, child. Another example sound, er, letters er in water, tester, developer. Synthetic phonics is taught in a multisensory approach. There's usually a story attached to it, there is a song, there is actions, and it is taught to very small children who are 2-3 year old. So we'll take a demo today. I am going to be your teacher and you're all my 3 year old pupil. And today we are going to learn the letter T. So this today, children, I'm going to tell you a story. We went to the picnic yesterday, do you remember?
Yes.
These children as well have gone to the picnic. Oh look, there is a cat, there is a teddy bear. And what are the children doing? They are playing tennis. And as the ball is going left and right, it's making the sound. And we are in the middle watching the ball left and right. So that's the action. So can you repeat top?
Top.
Tent.
Tent.
Cat.
Cat.
So that's the end of class today. Thank you, children. When children are taught in such a multisensory approach, it becomes easy retention. It's like they have their own version of Damsharat signals. Synthetic phonics was discovered by an English teacher named Sue Lloyd. She was assigned a special education class in 1960s. This was a class filled with children who had learning disabilities. And teaching them the regular way of ABCD did not make any difference to them. So she taught them the sounds first, and she saw that they were able to catch up. So next she taught this way to a regular class with regular children, and she was amazed with the progress that they were doing. So she wrote to the government of Britain, asking for this to be taught to every children who are learning to read. And the government asked for research. A lot of research has happened in different states in America, in various places in Australia, in Canada, in Britain. And they have found that this program is very beneficial. And a lot of letters have been up and down after with these through this research. And then in the year 2007, the government of Britain declared letters and sounds program as the only way in which young children are taught, are to be taught. Ever since I learned phonics, I am seeing that I'm doing less grammatical errors, spelling errors, my less autocorrects in my Word and Outlook. I'm teaching my daughter to read through synthetic phonics and she's doing good progress. So friends, today I leave you with an excerpt from the letter Sue Lloyd wrote to the government of Britain. A child that cannot read is a homeless child, while a child that can will be forever free. Thank you.